We're now joined by Dr. Harshvardhan, our health minister. Sir, in the last 5 years, we've all been talking about Swachh India, Clean India, and now we're talking about Swasth India and a healthy India. Do you think these conversations have created a conversation around the country over health, hygiene and sanitation?
Oh yes, significantly. I think there has been a sea change in the attitude of the people, and I think whatever the government has been able to do from its side, putting up over 10 crore toilets in the whole country and having more than 5,60,000 villages having become open defecation free. Very soon we'll be able to declare that the whole country has become open defecation free, and there is so much of thrust and so much of public awareness around these sanitation and hygiene issues. The sanitation coverage has gone up from 35% to almost over 97-98% in the whole country, and I think the happiest man around this is the health minister of the country, because I as a doctor also feel that everything that you do for sanitation or for Swasth Bharat, it contributes immensely to improvement of health status of the individuals at every level, and more particularly for the poor people, for whom the bad hygiene and the bad sanitation has its maximum adverse effect. So it has, I think we have seen there is a significant perceptible and measurable improvement in the health indicators in the country. All those cases of diarrhea, early deaths, and having those infectious diseases, communicable diseases so commonly affecting people, I think it's producing a sea change, and we need to take it forward in a big way. And I would like to congratulate NDTV and also Amitabh Bachchan ji, who has also spearheaded so many movements in the past, including my own passionate polio eradication movement. So this country can, I think, work wonders, and I'm sure that if we can really provide the successful implementation of the health for all goal of the World Health Organization, it is India itself which has the potential, the DNA, and the, I think, real spirit to be able to implement it. We very thoroughly believe that this cleanliness is, I think, next to godliness. This has been described in every religious text all over the world, and our people have all this ingrained in our DNA, and we have to only remind our people that this is so important, your personal hygiene. We have to take it to the schools, we have to make it a movement everywhere. And I know that under Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, with the inspiration of the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, we have done commendably well, and this is something which needs to be emulated by everyone. And in the next 5 years, and more particularly by 2022, we should be able to deliver a new India of the dream of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji.
Dr. Saab, this is Amitabh Bachchan. I just want to thank you for being with us and for giving us all these wonderful news on the kind of progress that India has made.
So happy. So
together on the polio campaign,
so happy,
and successfully sold. Today, India is polio-free after a long battle of almost 8 years. We worked together on that. We are now, as you know, and we've interacted with each other on diabetes, on tuberculosis, on hepatitis B, and we had Mr. Amitabh Kant telling us. Giving us statistics of the kind of progress that is being made. I just feel, Dr. Saab, that detection and testing whether somebody is suffering from that disease is a very important element. Many of us, because of either lack of funds or just being lazy, never want to go to a clinic to get ourselves just do a normal test and find out whether there is something wrong with them. We all know that diabetes is a silent killer. Many an individual who's suffering from diabetes is unaware that he's suffering from diabetes, right, and just one day becomes critical and passes away. We have, as you know, we have been working on tuberculosis and hepatitis B, but we need a lot of government support in these two ventures, Dr. Saab. You know, I keep quoting my personal example all the time and try and propagate the idea of getting yourself detected. And I don't mind saying it publicly. You know, I'm a tuberculosis survivor.
Right.
I am a hepatitis B survivor. A bad blood infusion went in and 75% of my liver is gone. But because I was able to detect it, even after a period of 20 years, when 75% of my liver is gone, I'm still surviving on 25%. And this is what I'm able to propagate, that get yourself tested, get yourself diagnosed, and then there is a cure, even with tuberculosis. I didn't know for almost 8 years that I was suffering from tuberculosis. And I keep saying with a lot of immodesty, if it can happen to me, it can happen to anyone. And therefore, if you are not willing to get yourself tested, you'll never find out, and there's never going to be a cure for it. So can we have some kind of government support in pushing these awareness campaigns, where we know treatment is there, but to push the individual to go and get himself tested, diagnosed, so that the ailment can be found out?
Thank you, Amitabh ji. I am so happy that you are talking about diabetes, hepatitis B and tuberculosis. And I think that means a lot to me, and that means a lot to the people of the country. You will be happy to know that all these diseases, and in fact all the other non-communicable diseases also, I think they are very high on the agenda of the government. As you know, by 2025, we want to eliminate tuberculosis in this country, although the international goal is to eliminate by 2030. And similarly for diabetes, hypertension and all these non-communicable diseases, I may tell you that the program that we have launched, the Ayushman program, has one component, which is the creation of the health and wellness centers all over the country. And we have a plan to create 1.5 lakh health and wellness centers by the end of 2022. We have already created 20,000. By March of 2020, we'll be creating another 20,000, and so on and so forth. And at all these centers, our basic aim, and I think the strength that we are going to create, and we are in the process of creating, is around prevention and promotive health, so that we can diagnose all these diseases early. Tuberculosis is one disease around which we have ensured that at every place, you see, even up to the level of the primary health center and the sub-center, we have mechanisms to diagnose early with sophisticated machines like CBNet, the sputum, and there itself, in the first instance, we diagnose whether it's a routine tuberculosis or whether it is a drug-resistant tuberculosis. For every patient of tuberculosis in the country, whether he is diagnosed in the private sector, the government provides 100% treatment, 100% facility for diagnosis, as well as treatment for drugs, etc. And the disease has been made notifiable. We have involved the private sector in a big way, and the results have already started showing. Similarly, it is true for the hepatitis B also. There is a great network of delivery of safe blood in the country, regional blood transfusion centers, the strengthening of the voluntary blood donation movement, and teaching people about the causes of hepatitis B, etc. So, in fact, I am very happy to inform you that government is also very, very passionate about it and is trying to use every possible means, trying to use technologies, trying to use apps, trying to use its network of 10 lakh ASHA workers all over the country, the Anganwadi workers and the health workers at the grassroots level facilities, that is the sub-center. And we are in the process of developing a very huge social movement, and with people like you, who have always helped the cause of health over the years. And I remember, as environment minister, last 2 years you helped me in propagation and strengthening of the Green Good Deeds movement also in the country.